plasmid isolation. In addition to chromosomal DNA, a bacterium may also carry an additional circular piece of DNA called a plasmid. Here, we will describe how to extract a plasmid from a bacterial cell. This procedure is called plasmid isolation. Procedure: take 1.5 ml or 1500 microliter of bacterial culture to a microcentrifuge tube using a micropipette. Centrifuge it in 5000 RPM for 5 minutes at 4 degrees Celsius. We can observe a white color settles down near the sides of the vial, which is called a pellet. Remove the supernatant and add 100 microliter of lysis solution 1 from the icebox to the vial containing pellet. Vortex it using a vortex mixture. Add 20 microliter of lysis solution 2 to the same vial. Now, invert the vial by hand 5 times as it can't be vortexed. Store it in ice for 1 minute and add 150 microliter of the lysis solution 3 to the same vial. Invert the vial again by hand 5 times and store it in ice for 3 to 5 minutes. Centrifuge the vial and observe that a lower layer of white precipitate is formed and an upper layer of plasmid. Transfer the supernatant liquid to a new vial and add 2 ml of 70% ethanol to it. Vortex the vial and allow to stand for 2 minutes at room temperature. Centrifuge it and we can observe the contents in the vial are separated as pellet and supernatant. Remove the supernatant and dry at room temperature. Add 1 ml of 70% ethanol to the pellet and centrifuge it for 2 minutes. Remove supernatant again and allow evaporation of the ethanol from the vial. Take 50 microliter of the reagent, TE buffer with RNase A, to remove the RNA contamination in plasmid. Transfer the reagent to the vial that dried. Vortex the vial and load it into the agarose gel with suitable marker to observe the DNA. The plasmid has proven to be a useful tool for the molecular biologist. Plasmids are useful to bacterial cells because they can carry genes which can allow the bacteria to multiply and create many copies of the gene. The molecular biologist can retrieve relatively large quantities of a protein produced by the bacteria or can use this arrangement to study the function of a particular gene.